Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and today we're going to build another kind of stove. What we have in front of me there is, I guess we'll call it a coffee carafe. That's a good word, but really it's a coffee pot. And it is a double-layered stainless steel. This one happens to be Mr. Coffee, but there's all kinds of different ones out there. I pick them up in thrift stores. It's a vacuum tank, double-layered stainless steel pot. And what I'm going to do is build a wood gasifier stove out of it. Okay, we're going to have to do this a little less conventionally than we might normally because I want to leave all the welds and everything together. And I'll get things set up and I'll show you what I do as I go along. Okay, obviously the first thing we've got to do is get rid of this plastic handle and the plastic top. And right down here on the bottom, there seems to be a catch, but I will get it off of there, and after I get it off there, we'll take a look and see what we got. Now, I'm kind of making this video inside out because my brain said that this ought to work fine, but a lot of the research I did said it's not going to work. I want to get right down in there, and I want you to see that the flame is not down on top of the coals, but it is indeed up here. In fact, to prove that, I'm going to throw a little piece of paper in there, and it'll sit there, and if you watch, it's not being consumed right away. It's still there, which means there's no oxygen or hardly any there. Now, finally, it catches on fire. So that's not the heat of the flame, and that is basically proof of a gasifier that it gasified it. I can still see the piece of paper down in there. This flame is unbelievably hot. If it's not being disturbed, there's no smoke, or just a tiny little bit of smoke. I'm thinking I could use a little better secondary air mixture coming into it, but before I get deep into that, I'm going to go back and show you how I built this thing and what I'm using for fuel. This is my second burn, and it is with pretty much hardwood fuel. You can see right perhaps there in front of my finger how those jets are working quite well. I need to make them bigger. So after this cools off, I'm going to make those jets bigger, and I think that will help tremendously. I made some adjustments to my little coffee pot stove, and there she goes. Made a huge difference. Got a nice even flame now. I'm going to set this piece of an aluminum can on there. You can see I've already melted one in, so I know it melts it. I'll just watch it for a second here. See how long it takes. It's already burning the paint and everything off of it. We have a red hot glow in the middle there. See, the other side is already melted. There it goes. Broke in the middle, melted down. So it's melting aluminum. That's how hot it is. It's been burning for about 10 minutes. I expect it'll burn a long time. There's about 32 fluid ounces, but it's really not fluid. It's what wood. There's about a quart of wood chips and wood pellets down in that stove, making her go.
I burned it, this will be the fourth time now. This time I opened up these jets. So when it's done burning and cools off, I'll show you how I made it. And you can make one for yourself. Man, guys, I was going to finish this video up tonight, but this thing is still going. And I'll check my timestamp on these things just for kicks to see how long it's burning. But I've watched several videos. I've had supper. And it's been burning a long time. It is still extremely hot. That is one amazing little stove. Well, it's cool now. So I'll show you how I built it and why my brain said it should work, but the data that I saw said it probably wouldn't. Okay, the first thing that happened is I started to drill down here at the bottom and the bottom came off. Well, I didn't realize that bottom was a separate piece, but that really wasn't so bad. So after I got that off, I decided, well, I'm going to stick a drill right down through the top here, but my drill press head was, the chuck was too big to make very many holes. So I said, well, let's just flip it upside down and drill a bunch of holes clear through both layers. Now remember, there's two layers here. There's a layer here and there's a layer on the inside because this is a double layer. So I went ahead and drilled a bunch of holes around in circles to include clear out here at the edge. And then I set it down and I took a cutoff wheel, a 3-inch cutoff wheel on an air cutoff grinder, and I ground 8 slots around here. And eventually, as you saw from the earlier in the video, I had to spread those out. So I drove progressively larger punches into the edge until I got holes that are they're pretty close to 1/4 inch. They're probably a little bigger than 3/16, close to 1/4 inch, plus the slot. So we've got 8 pretty good size 1/4 inch holes here. All these holes down here are 3/16. I really don't think that it's all that critical. I think that if you make these holes down here too big, you're going to get too much air, you're going to get more gas than your stove might be able to handle. Okay, then I set it on the table and I said, well, now air can't get underneath that thing to come up through the middle because it's flat and it sits down, so I have to set it up on something. And my brain says, that is not a convenient thing to have to carry something around all the time to sit underneath it. So I just took my hammer and I folded this edge over in 4 places so that it made 4 legs on the bottom. Now, wow, that's pretty crude, but the whole idea was to prove whether this concept was any good or not. It works phenomenally well. It doesn't weigh very much. It holds a quart. What I was using for fuel, I started out with pine wood chips, horse bedding, and it burned very well with the wood chips. I filled it 24 ounces of hardwood wood pellets, pellet stove pellets, and then I put pine shavings on top of that to start it, and it burned for over an hour. And I finally got tired of it sitting out there in my garage, so I covered it up and snuffed it out. I don't have any idea how much longer it would have gone. It hadn't turned to charcoal all the way yet, but you know, you would have had half of this thing pretty much just charcoal, and that charcoal would have burned for a long, long time making heat. Now obviously you want to do this outside because when it gets to the charcoal stage, this thing is going to make carbon monoxide. And I'm sure there's a degree of that to begin with. But you know, for a little camp stove, if you wanted to haul this thing around, she's a pretty good burner. So I'll test that in future videos. I've got a couple more of these that I'm going to convert into stoves. But there you have it. You know, there's a whole bunch of holes. it's not as technical and critical as you might think. All of the tin can gasifier stoves that I made, and I made a bunch of them, I was very disappointed in every one of them because it seemed like the fuel was so touchy. If it was a little moist, or if it was a little bit the wrong size, or if it was a little this or that, they just didn't seem to work right. You had to fiddle with them all the time. But this one, you know, it didn't care if it was pine or if it was the hardwood chips or hardwood pellets. It burned just fine. So anyway, that's my first simple little wood gas fire. You can see it got so hot that it went from regular stainless color on the outside to a kind of a dusky brown. So it got that stainless pretty hot. Anyway, there she be. And got any questions, you know, fire them through to me. I'm going to build another one. We'll get a little bit more specific in the build on the next video. But that's basically my proof of concept project right there. Gas fire stove, a little bigger than a quart, burns for over an hour. Can't beat it. It's Kevin Bacon. Bye.